Have you ever been curious why some people drink their urine? Or have you ever tried to? Well, I certainly hope not. My name is Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today I'm reacting to an episode of My Strange Addiction called The Urine Drinker. If you're new here, I make content on urologic education, bladder health, sexual health, and much, much more. So if you like what you see, make sure you subscribe and share this channel with your friends.
On this episode of My Strange Addiction, a woman takes a shocking ritual to the extreme.
I'm addicted to drinking my urine.
I drink it like I'm in a beer drinking contest. Sometimes tastes maybe a little lemony.
Oh my God, this is too much. I'm gonna try not to. I'm not looking forward to this episode.
I drink it like I'm in a beer drinking contest. It's easier to drink than water.
For the past 4 years, Carrie has been drinking nearly all of her urine. It started as just one glass in the morning. Now she consumes up to 5 glasses every day.
I like warm pee. It's comforting.
Comforting? Oh my God.
First time I drank my urine, I didn't throw up, and it wasn't horrible. So I thought, you know what? I can do this. My urine does smell, depending on what I eat.
As I've mentioned in my previous videos about smelly urine, there can be lots of different causes of changes in the odor of your urine. Very often, it can be due to dehydration or things you eat or drink, like asparagus, for example, is something that can leave a very strong odor in your urine. Still, I'm really having a hard time with this.
Urine is your body's waste. It's what your body has decided to filter through and get rid of.
Yes.
So it doesn't seem healthy to me that to put that back into your body.
But Carrie doesn't drink urine just because she loves the taste. Her addiction began 2 years after being diagnosed with cancer.
I was diagnosed with malignant melanoma. Stage 3, and they took out 16 of my lymph nodes, found cancer in 3 of them under this arm. And they told me with the chemo I'd have a year to live.
Carrie decided against chemo, instead turning to urine therapy, an ancient and long discounted practice to maintain health.
I've heard of things like urine therapy before, and there are a lot of rumors that drinking urine can help with cancers or other sorts of body ailments and conditions, but there is no scientific evidence that drinking your own urine is going to have any benefit in combating cancer, treating chronic medical conditions, or anything like that. So I'm not an oncologist, but I wouldn't recommend avoiding chemotherapy if that's what your cancer doctor or your oncologist says to do for your cancer treatment. The fact that she chose not to take chemotherapy puts her at risk for spreading the cancer and getting more advanced stage of cancer, especially to do something like drinking urine, which has no known benefit in improving or killing cancer cells.
Carrie believes her cancer is in remission, but she hasn't seen a doctor in 6 years. And recently, Carrie made a discovery.
I have a mole that I've been watching. It's in the middle of my back. I can't say it's melanoma, but because it changes daily and it goes from dark to light, those are all qualities.
So for those of you who don't know, melanoma is a very serious type of skin cancer, and it's related to the cells in our skin that give our skin color, called melanocytes. And these cells can become cancerous, and they generally start from moles on your skin. And so dermatologists will recommend that you observe the moles on your skin and see a dermatologist regularly so they can examine you and see if there's any concerning findings for potential cancer. And warn warning signs are moles that start having irregular borders, start changing in coloration, or get larger over time. And so those are really concerning signs. And I'm really worried about Carrie because she hasn't seen a doctor in 6 years after being diagnosed with a very serious type of skin cancer, a very aggressive and very lethal type of cancer.
Aged urine is real good for lotion replacement. You put it in your skin and it completely changes the texture, moisture. This is my eye cup. And I fill it up with urine and then hold it over my eye with my eye open. It's not easy because it burns.
So urine as a baseline is not sterile. So I would not recommend putting urine in your eye. Anything that makes your eyes burn is probably not a good idea to put in your eyeballs. So urine is a substance that our body makes that is essentially taking all the waste from our body and filtering it through our kidneys. And it goes through a very extensive filtration process so that it's basically come down to the things that our body needs to get rid of in order for us to function appropriately. That's why when people stop making urine or their kidneys stop functioning, they need to go on something called dialysis so that their blood can be filtered appropriately. So urine is 90 to 95% water, but it does include a number of other things, including urea, which is a breakdown product of proteins, as well as creatinine, which is essentially the waste from our body, as well as a number of electrolytes, including sodium, phosphate, and other things such as that. So people do talk about drinking urine when they're in survival situations where there's no water available, but actually because of all these extra substances in the urine, if you drink it, it will actually serve not to hydrate you, but actually dehydrate you further. So it's actually not a good idea to drink urine if you're in a situation where you're maybe getting dehydrated. There are filters that are being made. In fact, I just read this article right here that talks about filters specifically that are made that can help filter out some of these substances to allow urine to be drinkable, which are certainly new and not widely available. So I would not recommend it unless you have one of these proven filters that makes urine safe to drink. However, urine is not sterile. A lot of people think that urine is sterile, but there's more and more data to suggest even in people who don't have symptoms of a urinary tract infection or feel completely normal, that there are low levels of bacteria in urine. So drinking it or putting it in your eye can actually cause you to get exposed to infectious diseases. Yeah, so don't put it in your eye. Or drink it for that matter.
Tell me what the purpose is behind that.
Well, I believe it's very much a natural thing that we are supposed to be doing. My body's cleaner, so it's making it cleaner.
And you know your body's cleaner, how?
By drinking it, it cleans it.
But how do you know that?
How do I know it feels clean? Well, less pain, agony, and misery.
So when people really want to believe that something is going to work, then they can very often actually start seeing proof that it's actually working. And that's called the placebo effect. And in fact, it depends on the specific condition, but we've seen placebo effects as high as in 50% of patients who are taking medication, a placebo medication for a certain condition. In medicine, when we want to make sure that something is effective for a condition, we do what's called a randomized controlled trial. And what that is we take people and we divide them into two groups. One group gets a placebo or a sugar pill if you're testing a medication, and the other group gets the active medication. And you compare those two to see that there's actually a difference. And if you look at all these randomized controlled trials of different medical conditions, you'll find that people in the placebo arm tend to get better because they will believe that they're getting a medication that actually gets them better. And so their symptoms will improve despite not getting any active medication at all. And this is probably what this woman is really experiencing, is that she believes that drinking urine is going to help her cancer and help her body feel cleaner, when in fact, nothing is really happening. In fact, she might even be harming her body.
What is it you would suggest?
In terms of your urine therapy, I would recommend taking a little hiatus for a while. And I suggest a biopsy of that spot on your back.
I'm very adverse to knives. this has grown from a very sick place inside. If we cut it from out here, it signals that inside, go bananas.
So I understand that people are very concerned when they're about to have treatments and they feel like they don't really understand the purpose of them. And so in this case, this woman is getting a biopsy of a suspicious lesion so that we can look at it under a microscope to see if it's cancerous or not. And we can't, in good conscience, do treatment for a potential recurrence of cancer if we don't know that it's cancer. In fact, treatment for cancer is actually to remove the cancer from your body, if it's possible. So if it's localized, very often the treatment for melanomas or other types of cancer are actually removing the cancerous tissue. And that doesn't cause spreading of the cancer. That's actually curative in some cases of cancer. Sometimes you'll require additional treatments to get rid of metastatic or disease that's advanced beyond the original tumor, or disease that's maybe microscopic that we can't see with our eyes on imaging tests that may be cancerous cells. And so you'll give treatment like radiation or chemotherapy to help treat those cancer cells that have spread. But it does not actually cause spreading of the cancer itself.
If you ever did consent to a biopsy and it came back showing that the cancer has recurred, would you ever consider that the urine therapy had failed and you'd be interested in pursuing something different?
Uh-uh. From everything I've read, if I quit, I'll die.
I encourage people to go ahead and search and read and learn about their disease process, but you need to know to look for sources that are reliable and that people have actually done clinical studies to prove that this is efficacious. I certainly know that there is a lot of things that we in the medical field are still studying and may not know and may have value, but it's important for everyone, including myself and my patients, to keep an open mind that maybe what they've read online is not accurate, and that they should consider that these people who spent many years training and educating themselves are the true experts on the condition. So I really hope this woman actually did okay, because I'm really concerned that she might not make it. Well, that was quite an episode. Bottom line, I really hope that Carrie stays healthy and gets the care that she needs. And I hope that people in general will not watch this and think that urine therapy is going to cure their cancer, because there's certainly no magical potion in urine that would have any benefit on preventing cells from multiplying and spreading in your body, which is essentially what a cancer does. If you have other episodes you want me to react to, please comment down below. And as always, remember to take care of yourself, because you're worth it.